Hi everyone, I'm Rama, co-founder and CEO of TOSAI, and in today's video we will train YOLO v7, which is the state-of-the-art object detection model at the moment, to detect guns on videos and images. So you can, for example, use this in a security camera to automatically detect any kind of danger situation involving a gun and notifying the police immediately so they can come to the place and make sure that no one gets hurt. All right, let's get started. Okay, so the first step to do is to go here and click sign up. Fill this form and click sign up again. You will have a new account on TIOS. It's totally free. But yeah, as I already have an account, I'm going to close this. I'm already signed in here. This is the library, if you haven't used TIOS yet, where you can see the algorithms we have, all the models. As you can see, we have most of the versions of YOLO, YOLO v3, YOLO v5, and YOLO v7. For this tutorial, we will use YOLO v7 Tiny because we want it to be as fast as possible, the inference. So yeah, this will be very fast. Also, we can try this inside TIOS with TensorFlow.js. You will be able to select that video from your local disk, so it's from your machine, and try it out in real time inside the website, or you can also use the webcam to try it out if you happen to have a gun or a fake gun. But yeah, I'm going to show you a little bit the dataset. You can of course upload the images yourself and try it out. In the free account, we have up to 1,000 images available. But if you want to have more images for free, you can reach out to us in our Discord server, and we can give it to you. We can give more images to you, so more available images to upload. So yeah, reach out to us, join the Discord server, and we can also help you there. All right, so here we have the labels. As you can see, this is a very simple dataset of guns. You just have to make let me show you how you can do this. You can click here, the class, and press your mouse and make the labels. Then you click submit, or press the E key for the shortcut to submit, or Q to skip. So yeah, I have this already labeled. So I'm going to go ahead to the train section of TIOS and create a new training session. I'm going to call this gun detector. I'm going to select the tiny version because, as you can see here, it has TensorFlow.js support. Yeah, so yeah, we want to try this in real time on the website, on TIOS. I'm going to select the guns dataset. And here you can select the machine. You have to select the machine you want to use for training. As I am in a professional account of TIOS, in the business account, I have two machines with GPU. But you can, if you are in the free account, you can use Google Colab. I'm going to show you quickly. So yeah, you just have to run these four simple commands, and this Google Colab instance will be connected to TIOS. Make sure that you are that Google gave you a Colab instance with a GPU, because sometimes if you recently used Google Colab, it won't give you a GPU. It will be only CPU, and that won't work. So make sure that it gave you a GPU. When you connect the Google Colab instance to TIOS, it will tell you right here, basically, in below, it will tell you if you have a GPU. If you don't have a GPU with Google Colab, you can log in to Colab with another Gmail account and it will probably give you a GPU. But okay, so I'm going to use this cloud machine. And yeah, this is the training session. This is where we will see all the training metrics coming to the browser in real time, like the fitness, average precision, the recall of the model. Yeah, this is if you want to select the initial weights to don't start, so the AI doesn't start from scratch. You can change this here, but I'm going to start from scratch. Sometimes it's better to do that. So yeah, this is the number of epochs, the number of the batch size. The number of epochs, if you don't know, is the number of times that the model will predict all of the images in the dataset. So one epoch will be like the model trying to predict the bounding boxes in all of the images in the dataset. So 300 epochs will do that 300 times, and with each iteration, it will be better and better at predicting the bounding boxes and the classes. We have only one class here, but if you have multiple classes, at first it will start to confuse the classes between them, and it's going to get better and better over time. Okay, so I'm going to go here and one more thing. If you have a few images, like 100 images, below 1,000 images, generally it's better to have quite a few of epochs. Like I typically, if I have 200, 300 images, I do like 1,500 epochs, because the AI will need a little bit more time to get better. But if you have a lot of images, it's okay to leave it at 300. So as we have like 3,000 images, I'm going to leave it there. Click Start Training here at the bottom. Okay, so now we have to wait. The AI will be trained automatically by Teo. So you will control the machine, download the dataset, and start the training, upload the weights, so then you can deploy the model and try it out. All right, guys, so now we're at epoch 176, but already it's looking pretty good. As you can see, this the fitness is 0.53. So yeah, above 0.6, 0.5 is already a pretty good model. So one of the great features of Teos is that we can go ahead and try the model as it's still training. So we don't have to wait for it to finish training. As soon as we see that the metrics are looking good, we can go ahead and create a new deployment and test it. So I'm going to go here to deployments and create a new one called GAN detector. Let's select the YOLO V7 Tiny. Now these are the weights. The weights, it's a file that encodes the knowledge of the AI. So you can think of it as the encoding of the strengths of the connections between the neurons of the neural network. So you have two types of weights. The best weights that were saved when the greatest fitness was achieved in the whole training, and the weights of the last epoch. So we want to try the best one. So we're going to select this, the type best for the dataset GANs, experiment one. So let's go ahead and click create. Okay, so now we have the deployment. This is the URL that you can send the images to and get back the detections. So let's go here to the playground and drop a new video to test. I'm going to drop this video here. And now it's loading the weights. And let's see. Thank you. Alright guys, with that we finished the tutorial. I hope you liked it. So yeah, you can use this model to create a security camera that automatically detects any kind of dangerous situation involving guns. Okay, so I'm going to link the dataset down below in the description, so you can download it and use it yourself. And also I'm going to go ahead and put the link for the Discord server where we can personally help you with whatever project you want to make inside TDoS with computer vision. So yeah, also feel free to leave any comment down below asking questions. Please like and subscribe if you like this video and want to see more of this content. All right, see you guys later. Bye-bye.